triad of a good time you had. There's a girl right next to you, and she's just waiting for something to do.
And there's a rose in the twisted love, and the eagle flies with the dove. And if you can't be with the one you love, honey, love the one you're with, love the one you're with, love the one you're with.
can you see? Maybe you'll bury me. If you're in a public eye, give us someone else a try. And you know you better watch your step, or you're gonna get hurt yourself. Someone's gonna tell you lies, cut you down to size. Don't do me like that. Don't do me like that. Boy, oh, I love you, baby. Don't do me like that. Don't do me like that. What if I need you, baby? Don't do me like that. Someone's gonna tell you lies, cut you down to size. Don't do me like that. Don't do me like that. What if I love you, baby? Don't do me like that. Don't do me like that. I just might need you, honey. Don't do me like that.
Hi. Thanks for coming back to join us. I just froze Nate with my hands. That's why.
You're like Sub-Zero.
I'm sure.
That's wow. Why if you're watching the video version of the show, you see what I did to him. This is my superpower. Okay. I'm here as always with my lovely co-host, Maddie.
Hello. Hi. Wow. What's going on there?
Lovely.
Hey, guys. What's going on? Hi. Yes. It's Maddie.
What is happening there? Oh, is it the light? Is it emphasizing your forehead?
I don't know what's going on. My hair's a fucking hoot.
Your beard is in a weird transitionary space right now.
You know what the problem is with it? It's on my face.
Yeah. But there was one day where you got it right.
That's
and then you ruined it.
That's a lot of things in my life. I'll get it, but then it's like it's in one ear out the other, and I just ruin everything. Mm. I'm gonna grow it until at least New Year's. Though I decided.
Gross. Oh,
that should be nice and long.
Yeah, I've never done it before.
It's gonna be so bad.
2 weeks was the longest I went, and that was like a couple weeks ago, before Halloween.
How long are we looking at right now? What are you sitting on?
The 26th was the last. Sorry, a week ago.
It's almost a week's growth.
Two and a half? One and a half? One and a half.
One and a half weeks.
A full one and a half. Yeah, it doesn't grow fast at all.
Wow. They have this thing where you grow your beard for charity. Have you guys heard of that?
That's like Movember, right?
Oh, yes. Yeah. I believe so. Yep,
yeah, I want no part of that.
No.
I'm doing this for my own selfish reasons. Don't be mistaken.
I decided to grow my beard on November 1st, but it has nothing to do with that. So, and of course, the other one is here with us, Nate.
Hello. How is everyone? Good to be back. Thank you.
How are you?
We have two guests with us today, two brand new guests. This guy you may recognize if you're a fan of Gas Digital Network. He's been on shows on the network before, a comedian, and you may have seen him on America's Got Talent, Gary Veeder.
Oh, thanks.
Thank you for being on the show.
That was such a big intro.
You have this like similar voice tone of Jacob Williams.
Oh, yeah. We went to school together. No, I don't know. We had the same speech coach.
Okay, so. Now let's see how I do with this introduction. Let's see how I do this. So, she's an intuitive.
Yes.
And hosts a get togethers, meet and greets with people on the first Thursday of every month. And a few lucky people win a raffle for her to read them.
Yes.
So she helps people. She can read their past, present, and future. Mm-hmm. Natasha
Leith. Short for Lethal Weapon.
Yep. Leith Hamilton.
I just got married this past June.
Congratulations.
So I'm still dealing with the Hamilton part of it.
Got it. But thank you for being here today.
Thank you.
We hope maybe you can help us all.
Sure.
Maybe you can help all of us.
Good luck.
That sounds good. Good luck, right?
Yeah. I saved some of the personal stuff I want to talk about for the next episode so I don't take away too much from you guys. But there is one thing that I want to share. I put out a Twitter poll earlier today. And I wanted to find out what the listeners enjoy about the show more, what they enjoy about it less. So do you have the Twitter poll that I sent you, Brian, the image? So I just want to show you where it is so far. It's not the full 24 hours yet, but we have quite a few. So I asked, what's your favorite part of the thing is? Me yelling at Maddie, scary things, bad things, or worst date stories. So me yelling at Maddie is ahead, 38%.
Glad I can contribute.
People love it.
Happy to be a part of things over here. The
and
thing
we
is,
consistently give people what they want.
There you
Every
go.
Episode, you're horrendously disappointed with them at least
that's
once.
That's true. Yeah. And the more he drinks, the worse he gets. So he's drinking, so that's good.
Good.
And
bump that on up to 42% at least.
And then next up was scary things, then worse dates, then bad things. It seems people don't like the fight stories as much as I do.
It's just not their favorite part. It doesn't mean they don't like it. Maybe they just like ghost stuff better, or they just really love you yelling at Maddie. I get it.
Yes, that's true. That okay. So before we get into your guys' stories, how... That's okay. It got brighter because we want to see more shine on Nate's head. Natasha, or do you want me to call you Tosh? What do you prefer to be called?
Yeah.
Tosh. Okay, so
Natasha fast. Back.
There's Natasha. That's Tosh.
That's Tosh. Yep.
So would you call, now you haven't seen, I haven't seen you use this word anywhere, but is what you do some kind of psychicness?
It is. I just don't like to use the word psychic because my gift is very natural. Like I don't read tarot cards. I don't read palms. Like I literally can look at someone and tell them everything that's going on in their life. Like this is an ability my family realized when I was 6 years old.
Okay.
So I have these monthly meeting greets because all of my sessions are over the phone. I work with a lot of celebrities in the industry as well. They usually fly me out to them. But most of my clients are over the phone and I work with international clients as well.
Awesome.
So I guess you can call me a psychic, but I just don't like using that word because I don't know what they worship.
Got it.
So my gift is unactual.
Okay.
Yep.
Would you be able to give a few lines to each of the people in the room and tell us what you think about us?
I could. I had like six sessions today.
Okay.
So I'm a little bit drained.
Okay. A little vodka?
Yeah.
Do you?
That probably would help, actually.
Okay. Do you want some vodka, Gary?
What?
Do you want some vodka?
Then I'll be
vodka?
Stumbling out of here.
Oh, wait. Do I need... No, I'm good, actually. Yeah. I was thinking, no, like... I would, so you're drained. You can't do the
room. I can. I mean, I can probably see like brief stuff, but I did like six full hour sessions today.
Yeah.
Starting from this morning. So I am a little bit drained.
Okay. We'll take a little, if you want to do a little bit for each of us, if I can just get
myself together and then I'll just randomly, if that's okay with you guys.
Yeah.
Randomly say personal things about each of us.
Perfect.
Uh-huh. Is that okay with you?
That's totally fine.
Okay. Okay.
So we'll start with the stories then. And as things come to you, you let us know.
Absolutely.
Okay. So, I feel like, did you, which is one you had to think about? Your worst date story?
The date one, yeah.
Okay, sure. So we'll start with you, Tosh. What's your nightmare date experience? Preferably first date, doesn't have to be.
So I went out with a guy one time and it was a great date. And we went to Atlantic City and we were in the hotel just hanging out drinking. Mm-hmm. And he actually like urinated all over himself.
He got so drunk that
he literally urinated all over himself. It was embarrassing. And it was just, I just wanted to go home because he was smelly. It was just terrible. So that was one of my.
That reminds me. That was actually mine as well.
That really?
Yeah, that was me. That story.
And where was this?
In Atlantic City.
Oh, okay.
We went to Atlantic City, him and I, and he got so drunk that he literally urinated all over himself. It was disgusting.
Did he like pass out and did it?
No, he was just awake. Like, we were speaking and he just started like pissing on himself. Wow. And I was like, are you peeing on yourself right now? And he was just like looking at me and I was like, okay, this is gross.
He's like, I don't know, am I?
And he was a pastor. I like, how embarrassing, right? Like, I was like, where's your like mannerisms? It was gross. So that was it for him.
Maddie, for someone who pees and poops themselves pretty often.
Yes.
Very frequently.
Have you ever done it? Have you ever peed yourself while conscious?
Yes. Yeah.
Were you drunk?
No.
Really?
There was one time I didn't make it. No, two times. Oh my God. I might have been drunk that time. No, but there was one time for sure when I was riding my bike home and I was like 9 from school. And I got to my drive when I just fucking, it was just done. It was over.
But you're a guy. You can just pull it out and pee in the street.
Yeah.
Wherever you are.
I don't want to take my penis out in the driveway, Shannon. Is that not like a fucking the suburbs? You know what I mean?
Maddie, you're gay.
Yep.
So there's like no one around, like bushes and trees everywhere.
I mean, the neighbors are kind of sort of close together. It was open air. It was just done. You know what it was? I took like one step and it was just over. It was in no man's land. It was either take my pants down in the middle of the driveway or just deal with the shame.
I have a question.
I went shame, yes.
Do you always wear two rings?
I go in and out.
I don't think I've ever seen you wear rings before.
I have.
Okay.
Yeah. You just don't notice me anymore, Shannon.
Oh, I notice the annoying things, and the rings are bothering me a little.
Yeah. Like I said,
trying to so really right?
Are you married? Are you not? Like,
I know my audience, Shannon.
Right.
So you didn't want to whip your penis out, but you were happy to stand in the driveway just pissing all over yourself.
Well, I didn't just stand there. Just like went as I went.
The jumping jacks.
I went as I go. Goat as I whatever. Yeah. Yeah.
How about you, Gary?
I've shit myself before that happened.
Oh, there's our new first segment.
The amount of times that this segment has turned into
are we talking
people.
About bad date or shit? Which one?
Peeing yourself right now.
Oh, okay, yeah. Well, I'm sure there's some piss that came out while I was shitting, you know? That happens frequently, so.
Frequently.
Little urination. No, you know, you're shitting and then you have a little.
I never piss when I shit. I find it odd that people do.
Yeah, so it's a combination. You're shitting yourself, but you're also peeing yourself a little bit. But anyway, on the train, I shit myself. I was going like I needed to get from like Times Square to like 28th Street, and I was like, I'm like hoping that I could just like make it, get off the subway, and then get to the apartment that I was going to. And then it's just like as soon as I was getting up the subway stairs, just started coming down my leg.
Oh my God.
And it was just terrible. I had to get back in a cab and like go back to Astoria, just to like get new clothes.
But then sit in the cab, smelling up the cab.
Oh, yeah. It was disgusting.
Oh, my God.
It was all over my shoes. Nice Nike Air Maxes gone.
I want to say something.
Nice to
Gary.
What's up?
There we go.
You seem like a person who shits himself.
I start wearing
sometimes.
A diaper again.
I'm picking it up. So my hands start to sweat when I'm picking up energy from people. So my hands are actually starting to sweat.
I'll take your word for it.
Okay. Something's coming up to me with you with Netflix. You'll be working on a project with Netflix is what I'm picking up.
Oh, nice.
I don't know if anyone's reached out to you or your team or whomever, but I'm sensing something with you with Netflix, which is a big and great opportunity for you, so you should be really excited about that. Is that something that you ultimately want to do, or is that a direction that you want to go into?
Yeah, that'd be great. I mean, I need maybe it's, how do you know it's not like just like a membership?
No, it's not a membership. No, it's not like, a membership. It's actually. Is that on
you? Or they're going to like sue me because.
Share your password.
Yeah. I've been using some.
No, this is a good
password.
This is you actually working on a project with Netflix, is what I'm picking up. Which is you should be very excited about.
Thanks.
That.
Have you pitched anything to Netflix?
No. But how about death? Anything about death in there?
Are you
like,
dying?
Am I going to like. No, but am I going to just, you know.
They're going to film your death on Netflix.
Yeah, right, exactly. Yeah.
And you shit yourself right as you die, so it all comes full circle.
There we go.
I kind of have a question about the shitting yourself thing. I feel like you guys aren't taking sharts into account.
Excuse me?
Right?
That counts. That counts as shitting on yourself. It does.
Gary's story was a legitimate shit.
Yeah.
I've done that once, but
okay,
I
shart
very frequently. No. Go ahead. Let's How many times have you shat yourself?
This is the unofficial first segment.
Okay.
Of the show.
So, have you guys, it's these diet pills that you take.
Yeah.
I think it's called Ally.
I had a shit on Ally.
It's terrible.
Yeah, they're not good.
It's like oil. It's terrible,
yep,
right? So, I was in Rite Aid. Thank God I was in the corner of my house and I was doing this diet thing and I literally shitted on myself from Rite Aid. Like, it came ran into my boot. I was so embarrassed.
I'm just loving that this is like the third time that the date section has been fucking hijacked by stories of people shitting and pissing on themselves.
It was so embarrassing.
You can't get this from another show, though.
Well, that's the thing with Ally. They don't tell you. You can't fart after you've taken it.
I'm telling you. No, seriously, they need to take it off the market. It's terrible. Yeah.
Is it still on the market? I haven't seen it advertised in a while.
I think it is. I don't think it advertised it, but it is. But it's terrible. Hmm. It's just, it's not safe.
Well, that's like the Olean potato chips. Weren't they also making people shit themselves?
Mm-hmm. Oh, I never had
it
one.
Was like
you
the,
try it.
They were like less fat or something, but the way that your body processes it, you just like... shitting out oil.
Yeah.
It was Ally was just dangerous. No.
All right. Have we killed enough time yet for you to have thought of a bad date story?
I didn't even know I was supposed to do it. I don't really think I honestly, like, anytime I was on an actual date, I was happy to be on it. That was it. So it was like, it was so hard to meet anybody that I was just thrilled to be on an actual date. They definitely did not have great times, but that said, I never really, I was always just happy to be on one, you know?
It's a great way to look at it.
Yeah.
That's
nice.
That means
that's how sad and desperate I was. Yeah. Okay.
You're a bunch of other people's worst.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, but... totally. I'm number one for a lot of people. Yeah. But yeah.
Let's go then in a more positive direction then. So you're married.
Mm-hmm.
How did you meet your wife?
On the subway, actually.
I just shit myself.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. That's a good one.
She was a cashier at CVS, and she rang me up.
So she was on the subway, and you started a conversation with her?
She was sitting down on a on the train. I just boarded, and then, like, there was a seat open next to her. I sat down in it, and, like, she sneezed, and, like, I said, God bless you, and then we, like, started talking from there.
Wow. Great.
That's nice.
Yeah, yeah.
I met my husband in an Uber.
I read that about you.
Yeah,
oh, nice.
I met my husband. I read him in the Uber and told him everything about his entire life. He was shocked. And then I was like, you're my lifetime partner. I kind of like hostage him. And he was like, yeah, sure. Yeah, I'm your lifetime partner. And then we like started dating and then we got married. Engaged a year later, married this past June.
I'm going to try that the next time I see a hot guy.
You take a lot of Ubers?
Yeah, you want to take a boat ride?
You're my lifetime partner. It actually works, right?
That's great. I'm going to give that a shot.
It like, works.
People meet on planes, stuff, you know? I think all that stuff is...
I just feel like you don't hear about people actually meeting in real life for the first time
so often.
Yeah,
it's different.
Yeah, because people are meeting from apps so much.
I don't trust apps. I don't. People are crazy.
I think more people are, like, if they can meet somebody outside of it, they're more open to it. Now it's
Yeah.
I don't know. I still haven't deleted Hinge from my phone. I have Hinge on my phone, but I'll like scroll through every so often. I'll respond to one or two things and I'm not excited about anybody. Like, I want there to be like a picture of someone or something someone says where I'm like, ooh, I can't wait to see if they respond. And
do you remember like in the beginning when people would online date and it would be like, oh man, you're such a fucking loser. Now it's just like, then people just start it just becomes so natural that so many people just do it. more people that do it than don't do it.
Yeah. A friend of mine, when I went to their wedding, and they were embarrassed to tell people that that's how they met.
Yeah.
Really? This is years ago though, because like now it's so commonplace. Mm. But yeah. And I used to work at a bridal salon, and people would like whisper to me like, oh, we met on J-Date. And I'm like, why are you whispering? Right. Yeah. Right. Because, yeah, no, it's because like what you said, it was like an embarrassing thing.
At least they have
thing.
A man. I mean, yeah. All and a huge ring.
Yeah, like match. It's like almost like it says where you met. Like if you're like, oh, match.com, it's like it's kind of sad. Like, you know.
Yeah.
Well, it is like
LinkedIn. I don't know. Right.
LinkedIn is a good one.
Yeah.
At least probably they have a job. Yeah. Right? Yeah. At least they're employed.
It probably is the stigma of it being easier to find someone online, because you're just putting a profile out there and matching
it's
up.
Not easier, though.
But it has to be, so. Because it's... They're doing the matchmaking for you. That's the whole idea
no,
of those
not.
Sites.
You're just swiping yeah. through people, just like you do when you walk down the
well,
street.
Well, that's what a guy who's trying to get laid does, but like a lady might.
Yeah, but you still don't know anything about them. It's just like it's like a job. You still have to like.
But for like
you still interview them.
But for the real sites, like Match, right? Don't they have online profiles where like you can kind of get an idea of like,
yeah,
oh, this person is this person.
They're filling that out with stuff that's like along with their picture of them next to a tiger. You know, like
yeah, but you're still,
they're just trying
it's
to
a false
show
perception.
You.
Exactly.
You're still narrowing it down a little bit. You can at least say like, oh, this guy fucking
the
wants
same thing.
Kids,
like if you're walking
kids,
down
dogs,
the street
like dogs.
And how somebody is dressed, how they carry themselves as yeah. they walk down the street. You're like swiping right and left all the time as you walk past
yeah,
people.
But, yeah,
I just
but
never
for,
swipe right.
For actual appearance.
Yeah.
I'm talking about like the little bit that there are profiles. Right. Like Lainey got married on from Match or whatever. Right. Mm-hmm. Or eHarmony, one of those fucking sites.
Her husband so. Was really cool.
And they seem happy, you know? He seems right. like a cool guy.
He is.
They probably just fucking, you know, you click.
Yeah.
You're putting your shit out there. It's like, you know, here's my resume, everyone.
Says the person who's never been on a dating
show. I know! I want to break up just to go on one. I envy all of you.
It's crazy. I actually read pictures as well, right? So... Interestingly enough, a lot of my friends who are on dating apps, they would like show me the guys and show me the pictures, and then I can tell them like, okay, he's this, he's that, he's this, he's that, and then they select from there. So I make their lives a lot easier. Oh. So yeah. That's fun. So if anyone's looking for dating app, I can help with that.
Oh, good.
As well.
Maybe you can right. swipe through all of my guys and my Hinge, and then tell okay. me which one I should respond to.
Got it. That'll be fun.
And if you that's tell me fun. If you tell me to go on a date with one. I will do it.
Okay.
Okay.
Let's do it.
Oh, jeez. Just, yes. pick one.
Just pick one.
Whatever.
I feel like it changed with you in terms of like your living situation is going to change is what I'm picking up. I read past and I read present.
Well, I have changed in the past.
Well, of course, duh.
Nailed it.
But I'm getting a foreign country.
You've not always been in this exact
but
place.
But I'm picking up like you. There will be another purchase is what I'm getting. I figure there will be a property purchase with you. That's what I'm
a
getting.
A property purchase?
Yes.
Wow, you're going to buy
again,
Australia.
Could it be like a video game?
A video
does
game?
Does it have to be a property?
Do you count that as a property?
I mean.
You're going to play Monopoly soon.
Right. Okay. Even right. that is doubtful.
Hotels, right?
We'll see. That's a lot of shit is going to have to change if I'm buying a property. Jeez.
Can you tell a time frame?
I'm picking up years. Around about like 2 to 3 year time frame.
Fucking
okay.
hell.
No, all it's right. still cool.
Must mean my wife is about to get successful.
She's gonna get a
raise.
Love it.
Thank you. I'll let
you're
her know.
You're a non-believer, aren't you?
Yeah, of course.
I can tell.
Yeah.
I can feel your energy on that.
Yeah.
That's fine.
I'm not like hostile.
I mean, I caught
like
the fucking
fun.
Sarcasm in his voice. Of course, like anyone can catch that.
It's just his accent.
Oh, that's
his
what it
accent
is.
Is actually pretty cool.
It's,
I like
you know what
accent.
It is that appreciate snarky it. English accent that really.
Fuck you, man.
Yeah, he's British.
Yeah,
not English.
Yeah,
no. You are scum.
Yeah. Sorry. Actually, you're gonna be deported. That's
is that the change? Yeah. Did I say property purchase? Yeah. I meant getting deported. Cross those fingers, Brian. It's not happening.
You're going to be going to a different property.
All right. We're going to switch over. I want to save the scary things for the end because I have faith that Tosh is going to have a really great scary thing story. So let's do bad things first.
Imagine if the Tosh just wins the best of all.
Actually, speaking, this is not a bad thing or a scary thing. This just came to my mind.
Yeah.
I just watched the Netflix show Unbelievable. Has anyone seen that?
No, I've heard of
no,
it.
No, but Gary's going to be on it.
I hope not, because it's about a serial rapist.
Ah.
But then Gary's going to be on it. No,
I pick up on things too, Natasha.
it's based on a true story. It's about a serial rapist and how it was like, I guess like the mid... I don't know where places are. Like Washington, Colorado, over there. And
love rape out there.
This guy did, and he, like, I don't want to give it away if anybody wants to, like, watch the show. It's, like, 8 episodes, and while I got my hair done, as you can see, my colors are back, everybody. Nice. Thank you. This is how you know how long it takes me to get my hair done. I was able to watch the entire series, 8 episodes, while I was at the hair place.
What? That's crazy.
8 episodes.
How long? And you didn't go numb? Half hours? Either way, it's a long fucking time.
It's about 7.5
That's
hours.
A whole day. You should get a paycheck for that. Yeah. They should be paying you.
I agree.
Right. That's a long time.
For her standing on her feet behind me for 8 hours.
God.
But so anyway, so afterwards, what?
Well, it looks great.
Thank you.
It does.
What happened in the show is, I'll just start from the beginning so I'm not ruining anything, but this guy would, like, go into chicks' houses, but like through open doors or windows. So it's not, he's not breaking in really. He's just getting in there. And
tell me you're not on this guy's side at the end of this story.
No.
Okay.
Crazy.
Like, he's huge. I love him.
He was big, actually. I wasn't big. the actor who played the part, which I'm sure he's a lovely man. But it really freaked me out because the guy was able to, like, scrub the crime scenes where for years they had no evidence.
Oh,
they
wow.
could not figure out who this freaking guy was.
That's fucking smart.
it was just terrifying. So now it's harder for me to sleep.
Is this like based on a real yeah. How long?
Yeah, it's based on a real story.
Must be a while ago.
I can't remember. Where I feel like the 90s. It's on Netflix. Yeah, unbelievable. It should be like coming up in your, like, trailers at the top. It's
does anyone get away with murders anymore? I feel like it,
of course.
Yes, there are cold cases out there.
Well, cold cases. I'm talking about, like, if you murder somebody today, right? What are the odds you get away with it? Probably not great.
I don't think so.
Unless it's a total stranger.
But I mean, people, like, let's say, like, cops.
I want to murder somebody. Give me tips.
Or unless they're connected, maybe.
Well, that too. Yeah. But, like, cops or like,
Epstein didn't kill himself.
There was another documentary, Murder in the Bayou. I think it's on Showtime or something like that, which was about this town. And this is recent. This is, like, up to, like, the early 2000s, where, like, young girls, but, like, this is, like, the poor side of town. And they were, like, hookers and drug addicts and whatever.
Yeah.
And the cops were involved in it. And they were just, like, wiping out all these chicks. And they, to this day, have never convicted anybody with the crime.
Mm-hmm.
And they know who did it. So, anyway. I don't know what that had to do with anything. I was just, because, like, it's between bad things and scary things and helping me sleep less. So watch Unbelievable on Netflix.
I'm going to look that up. My husband is really a movie guy, so I'm sure he would enjoy it.
It's a series, but it's quick. Or just get your hair done.
Watch just sit on the couch.
Okay, so this part of the show, we talk about bad things, physical altercations, fights that we've been a part of in our lives. This time we'll start with you, Gary.
Just a fight?
A memorable fight, if you have multiple ones.
All right. Well, when I was in college, this is my senior year. There was I was in a fraternity. Yeah, it was pretty big. It was pretty cool.
Pretty big deal.
So still part of that fraternity. You know, you never leaves yet. No. So I was like walking around like South Campus. I went to University at Buffalo, and apparently, like, one of the kids in, like, my fraternity got in a fight with another kid in another fraternity, and, like, I wasn't, like, ever into, like, the fraternity stuff, you know, like, any of that. So I, like, you know, I could care less that somebody got, like, a fight or whatever.
Even if it was
between those two people. I mean, friends, who knows? I don't even remember the situation.
His wife.
Yeah. Whoever it is, I don't talk to anymore.
Your mouth.
But anyway. So I'm, like, walking down the street, and then there's, like, these kids that were in that fraternity. They're, like, passing me, and they're like, "Oh, you're in Phi Delta Theta?" I was like, "Yeah." Like, "How's it going?" And, like, not friends. Knowing that, yeah, exactly, not knowing anything. And then one of them just punched me, like, right in my eye, and, like, I was just so, like, caught off guard.
Did he, like, knock you down? Or you
no, I just like I just like took the punch, and then, like, I was just like covered my eye, and then they just walked away, and then I was just like, okay. There was like four of them also. It's like, and also, like, even if it was just one of them, it was like, what was I gonna do? It's like, he stopped hitting me after one. I don't want to, like, you know, go near him again.
I don't want any more.
Yeah,
probably got more in the chamber.
Yeah, but yeah, I didn't go down, so that was good.
That's a good thing.
I had a little bit of a black eye.
So you look badass.
A little.
Yeah. It didn't color that well. So that, like, that was, like, the unfortunate thing. It hurt, and it should have, like, colored better. So that sucked. But yeah, that was the end of it, and nothing, you know, ended up happening to that kid. That was
definitely way more embarrassing if you get punched in the eye and take a seat from it.
Yeah, I mean, at least
you stood up. At least you didn't fall to the flat floor. So I'll give you.
Yeah,
it's not bad.
Yeah, I'm happy.
You're just a pacifist.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
You're a better person than he.
Yeah.
Have you ever in your life punched somebody?
Punched? No.
Have you open hand slapped somebody?
No.
No, so that's way more gas than punching somebody,
yeah.
Shannon.
Have yeah, when I was hand. A pimp.
Have you ever backhanded anyone?
Yeah.
Have you ever shoved someone?
Shoved?
Any act of aggression towards another
human? Have you ever talked loudly?
Yeah. No, I never. Yeah, I'm not like, you know, never. No physical type of, you know, altercation.
Do you drive?
Yeah, I drive.
Are you a road rage person? Or are you totally?
What do you think? What do you think?
I don't know. Some people are fucking nuts behind the wheel.
I'll say, yeah, like, oh, we're a fucking idiot, but not like, you know, I'm not like cocking a gun under my seat.
You don't
seat.
Look to see who it is.
Have
and
a baseball bat.
Pick a racial slur based on that person, like a piece of garbage.
No, you know, it's just like, you know, I see him. Is Chink racist, by the way? No,
yeah, can't be.
Ask Chink.
Not in traffic, though.
I'm just kidding. No, I am a fan of all races. Don't want anything to get construed here. No road rage.
What if you don't have kids, right?
No kids.
So what if?
Work out really, a hypothetical yeah, to coax him into a
no,
fight.
No, because I was gonna go. I was,
say you have kids.
What if you had kids? Yeah. So let's say your wife, because usually people are more protective over their kids than their spouse.
Yeah.
Let's say your wife, somebody was fucking with her, dude, was like pushing her or something.
Yeah.
You, what would you do?
Like, I mean that. I mean that.
Hey guys,
you mean, do I have to kill,
let's break it up.
To kill somebody. Here. Yeah. Like, what is this? Is my wife, so somebody has a gun to my wife, just like, I don't want any trouble, just get rid of her. Like, what?
That's cool.
Yeah,
but not a gun, like handsy, no weapons.
Yeah, I mean, I guess you have to, otherwise then she would have just, I mean, less respect than she already has for me.
Yeah, you'd rather be dead. Yeah,
she already calls me a pussy. No. So I was like, then I'll never hear the end of it.
Yeah.
All right, Tosh.
Okay. Well, I was taking the bus to Virginia, and a young lady while I was sleeping.
How old are you about?
Well, I'm 36 now, but at that time I was about like 21.
Okay.
And I was taking the bus to Virginia to visit my brother, and I fell asleep on the bus, and a young lady went in my pocketbook and took my iPod. Like, literally stole from me.
You saw her?
No, but I'm intuitive.
You felt it?
Right?
Got it.
Yeah. So I was like,
I'm so stupid.
So I'm looking for my iPod, and I was like, did you take my iPod? And she goes, no, I don't have. I'm like, okay, how about I know you have it? Like, can you just give it back to me? And she goes, I don't have it. You don't have proof. And I was like so pissed off. Like, I got up, and my brothers were sitting in the back of the bus. I told them, I'm like, I'm going to kick her ass. If she don't give me my iPod, she needs to give it to me. She kept refusing. And I literally took her bag and dumped everything on the floor on the bus. Like, just flipped it upside down and dumped everything. Found my iPod in her bag, and it was like beating her in the head with it. I was like, I fucking told you. I was so pissed off, but that's not like me typically, but I was so upset about her lying. Mm-hmm. And then I was like, okay, you must really need it because you stole it, so now you can keep it, after I like beat her in the face with it. So
and broke it.
Right. So I was like, you can keep it. So that's my bad thing.
She got an iPod out.
And a bruise on her forehead. Yeah, it worked.
I feel like that's worth it, right? Versus $1,100.
Right, but it was the old one, like the really small,
the heavy one, the one that really hurts when you get
right,
hit
the
head.
Yeah, I mean, the sharp edges on it. Yeah. Head with the coin. I was so frustrated because I was like, why would you go in someone's pocketbook and steal? Like, that's like a big.
Well, there's an iPhone in there.
Yeah, because it's easy.
Yep.
It was terrible, but I was pissed off. She was like paranoid. My brothers were like, stop. And I'm like beating her in the head with it. I was like, and she was like, oh my God. I was like, I felt horrible afterwards, but I was like pissed in the moment. So
did I ever,
that's my bad thing.
Tell the story of when I was robbed on the show?
No.
Go on.
It's such a stupid thing. And it's just because I'm like, I was so naive. I was like 21 maybe.
Yeah.
And I was at my parents' store. And so like the... I'm trying
what
to explain.
Kind of store is it?
It's that's a whole other explanation. It's like a fitness type place.
Okay.
And so it was the second floor. And so like you'd have to be buzzed in, and then you come up the stairs and you come in, and then you go to your right, and there's the reception area where I was. And then to the left, there's a hallway with like a bunch of doors for like the rooms for the workout stuff. Yeah. And so this guy came in, and he's
sounds like a massage parlor, by the way.
Right?
Just saying.
Sure. It was I was working for my parents' massage parlor. And
just be honest with us, Shannon.
And so I was in the front, and we had not like a register, but like a cash box, mm-hmm. because like most like people would buy like packages or whatever. Yeah. So it was like larger purchases and a credit card machine. And so this guy came in, and he was like kind of jacked. He was like a jacked older guy, like 50-ish. I'm looking everywhere.
He should have kicked his ass.
No, it was.
Shannon wanted to fuck him. Are you kidding?
He wasn't my type.
Oh.
But so he came in, and he was asking all these questions about the place and whatever. And then he's like, okay, cool. He's like, well, I have to go back to work, but I'm going to come by later. I'm like, okay, cool. So now I continue doing it. I'm going into each of the rooms, and I'm like setting everything up. It's early in the day. And then I hear something in the hallway, which you can't come up unless I buzz you in.
Right.
So I come and I peek out of the door where I am, and he's in the front in the cash box. Mm. So he must have like held the door open or put something in there downstairs and saw where the cat, like he just came in to scope out the place, saw it was just me there.
Right.
And then he came in and took the money and then like pushed past me, because like, I mean, what am I going to do? And then just ran out, and that was it. I got robbed. That was my only time getting robbed in New York City.
How much cash did he make away with?
I feel like it's maybe like $300.
Oh, no, that's not bad.
And it's my parents' business. It's like they were just fine. They were happy that I was okay.
Right, yeah, of course.
But, yeah.
And you had, but you had to pay him back, right?
No.
they got to teach you a lesson. That'd be great if it was just a setup. Like they just did that. It was like an in-house thing, scam.
They called the guy back to just pistol whip me.
Yeah, just trying to prove a point.
Right, left field, but you could have been a really good dancer. I don't know why I'm really good, like dancer.
I mean, again, I could have guessed that.
Yeah. Right?
Come on.
Lainey could have taken her as a client, because you know Lainey represents porn.
Yeah, right?
No, but no, outside of porn, like you could have been like a really, really good dancer. I don't know why I'm picking up dancing with you, but maybe that's something that
could be the tits. Just
it could the tits or the hair.
Sure, left field, fine, hair, but you know, could be.
Yeah.
Did you ever do anything like that?
I took like dance classes when I was like
younger.
Yeah, I'm trying to think, because my sister was there. My sister is 6 years younger than me, so I was maybe 9 or 10.
Mm-hmm.
But it was never really a thing in me, because then I took karate classes after, and that's something I continued doing.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, I wish I could dance.
Yeah, but I see dancing with you, and it could be because of the dance classes that you took when you were young, but I see dancing with you.
I mean, I'm not.
Feels like an insult to me, Shannon. I'd fight her.
I'm sorry. That's, I mean, we are
give her
on the
a
topic.
New story.
She's like, get comfortable with the pole. That's
the topic,
what I see in your
right?
future.
Not do you feel pole. Any trauma
but
from
I
that?
See, I saw the dancing with you. That's why it came up for me, because I did see you dancing. Because I read past whatever, but I do see you dancing. And if you would have stuck with it, you would have actually been great.
Cool.
But you didn't.
It's fine. Now you're going to be a failure.
Right. No. Yeah.
made a lot of bad decisions.
Right? Look where I am, everybody. This is where I spend my days.
This is actually good. Nice studio.
Yeah, thank you. Do I have trauma from it? I don't
think
so. Yeah,
feel like it fucked you up at all? No?
No.
Scale 1 to 10?
I mean, I don't know. Maybe back then there was more of something. I don't really remember it.
Just kind of like it was
that's
a blur.
You stopped your dancing career. That's where it all ended.
Tell Lainey.
It's all coming together.
Gas digital.
Right?
All right. Let's go ahead and move on to scary things. We can lower that 2 degrees, maybe. All right. This is the listener's favorite part of the show, apparently.
Really?
No, it's not. Shannon.
All right, second favorite part, aside from me abusing Maddie. So this is the part of the show where we talk about scary things, possibly paranormal, weird, creepy stuff that's happened to us in our lives. Because I feel like Tosh has to have an amazing story. We'll start with you, Gary, so you don't have to follow her.
Okay. How do you know mine isn't as amazing?
I hope
but no. But yeah, I'm sure you got some crazy shit. So I always wonder, you always want to know if like there's a God or not or whatever, or some fucking thing out there. Who doesn't want to know?
Sure.
But I remember I was going to bed. I was like maybe like 8 years old, and I'd always have to go to like Hebrew school. I'm Jewish, by the way.
And, wait, what?
Yeah. It'd be weird otherwise.
Yeah, no, we look alike. You're Jew, right?
No.
Really?
No.
Uh-huh. Jew face. Where you at?
Right?
Are you?
What's a Jew face?
Being asked if you're Jewish is the only thing you can respond
so
to with like, yeah, it's like it's an insult. Like, no,
what's
not.
A Jew Brian, I need... If it was clean, I need Gary's Jew face to Maddie. I need that. If it was clean.
I do have that nose.
No.
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 Don't.
Am I a Jew?
No.
What, do I look cheap?
You're a Jew? I don't know. I feel like everyone's Jewish. You got something going on. No, you're like from Australia. So.
There's no Jews in Australia.
There's mad Jews in Australia.
Kangaroos are Jewish. The dingo ain't
Well, the episode title.
But anyway, so I had Hebrew school. I'm about 8 years old, and I fucking hated it. It's like the worst thing. It's the most boring thing. And you go to Hebrew school right after you went to your regular like elementary school, you know? So I remember going to sleep one night, and I used to have this thing, like it was like a Superman character. It was like one of those, like it would like stick to like a shelf in my bedroom. Mm. It would be like half of his body on one side and the other half on the other. Like, so it looked like he was flying.
Yeah, okay.
Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. And then, so this thing used to like fall all the time, but for whatever reason, it was on like a streak where it hadn't fallen in like, I'd say like 3 years.
Oh, wow.
And so right before I'm going to bed, I'm like, you know what? It would be great if there is a God. I would start believing from this point on. Mm. But, you know, make it snow outside. That's what I said out loud. I'm like,
is it July?
No. This is like, you know, this had to be like, I want to say like December. So, and then I'm like, you know, and then I go, also make the Superman, like, you know, fall down like it used to, like, so. And I'm like, and I also don't have to go to Hebrew school because of the snow.
Mm-hmm.
So the next day there's snow on the ground. There was no school at all. And then there's no Hebrew school, and the Superman fell. So I was like, oh, that's, I mean, I guess I have to believe in God. But then the next night I'm like, all right, do it again. I'm like, come on. I will fucking really believe. But that was it.
So but, what are your thoughts today?
My thoughts today is that, yeah, there's something, you know, out there in general, like you know, just powers. Or yeah, just like, yeah, I mean, we're all here for, you know, some, I don't know why, you know, well, it's weird that we're here. So I think there's meaning deeper than like we can imagine. It's not just like, oh yeah, go through like the mundane things of life for like no reason. Mm-hmm. There's just something that, you know, brought us all here. That's like, you know, we're so small in this huge, huge universe that it's like, it's completely odd.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so there's got to be something in my mind.
It does feel like it's too complex to not be anything beyond this.
I mean, I feel like I gave a pretty good, you know, description of what's going on. No.
nothing needed to be added.
Superman.
Yeah, yeah. No, but totally, yeah. It's so complex that it's like, how can there not be something? When just like, we're not the, it doesn't seem like we're the only ones, period.
Right.
Like, you know, it could be humans somewhere else. There could not be either, you know.
But on the flip side, just to play devil's advocate.
There's nothing when you die. You're no, just but worm it's, food. You're dark all of a sudden.
No, but it's also like, our human brain observing our environment.
Mm-hmm.
And it could just be us trying to make sense of something.
Yeah, but why bother trying to make sense of it? The deer don't do that. They just get hit by cars.
You don't know.
Because they're stupid. They don't even look twice before they cross the street.
But you know what? Like, once animals become domesticated,
yeah,
like a dog,
right?
That's the only real domesticated animal, yeah. They start to have like human traits. So it's like there's something about like once humans like got into the agricultural age,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
is when we started evolving for real.
Right. Yeah, for sure.
And maybe that's an accident.
I think that wasn't supposed to happen.
I don't know. I'm just playing devil's advocate because I don't really believe that. But it's just who freaking knows? We're not going to ever know. Maybe.
We might. You don't know.
But we might. Because right? Like I say it all the time. Like my hope is that it's at the end, big picture. You're shown everything. Why
I don't
want to
see everything.
I want to see everything.
No, there was some fucking drunken wedding sex over the weekend. I want no part of a second time.
What?
I don't want to. Don't expand on that.
Just no.
I just leave it.
Save it. We all have those blackout moments we don't want back.
Wait, drunken wedding sex?
Fuck's sake.
Like, you think you got drunk at a wedding and had sex with someone else?
No, I had open bar sex. You know, where you're just like, you've been. It's just. You tried. You tried, Nate.
When?
You tried.
You've been married to the same chick for 15 years.
What do you mean? I didn't hear it.
He said you've been married to the same chick for 15 years. When?
What?
God damn it. I can't. Never mind. It may have gone to a fun place, but because
I went to a wedding and I got loaded. Listen, I don't want to see what happened on Saturday is my point.
This past Saturday?
Yeah.
You went to a wedding without Aaron?
No, we were there together.
So you think you had sex with Aaron?
Yes, no, I know I did. It was bad.
Do you think you had sex with someone else?
No, I had bad blackout sex with Aaron. I thought that was clear.
You're gay. This is why the listeners like for me to yell at you, because they want to be able to, but they have to do it through me.
Continue. Carry on.
And that's why you don't want to know the secrets of the universe, because you had sloppy sex
with your girlfriend. Okay.
Correct. Thank you for getting it, Nate.
I get it, but I'm just contextualizing. I will say this: if you let me do the episode where we smoke DMT, you will know the secrets.
No,
you especially, Maddie.
No.
Brian's nodding. He knows.
Maybe.
Wait, didn't he agree on something? Did he agree on Molly?
He agreed to either do Molly or Ambien.
Right.
And I said, why can't we do both? And you said, no, we can't do both.
Please, I'm still a baby in the drug world.
Me too.
Are you crazy? I smoke marijuana, but that's the furthest that I would go. You know? And even that gives me panic attacks.
Yeah, I hate marijuana.
I take like 50 showers like after
pot
I smoke.
Pot makes you freak out, but psychic ability, you're like, no, totally cool.
Seriously.
I'm all right with that now. I would.
Like literally.
Inverse.
My husband always knows when I smoke. My husband works for NYPD. Okay.
Oh,
right?
Boy. Oh, he's not an Uber driver anymore.
Yes. No. Well, he was doing that on the side and he was working for NYPD.
Yeah.
So I went, like, whenever I smoke, I go in and out of the shower. Like, if he's like, you must be high. I'm like,
they just laugh in his face.
Yeah.
Like, what makes you think that?
I kept forgetting stuff I needed outside of the shower.
Right. It's terrible.
All right. Let's hear it, Tosh.
So my most scary thing was me kind of predicting the Twin Towers, when the Twin Towers collapsed. So the day before, I literally had a dream about planes going into the Twin Towers, people running and smoking. I told my mom, I was like, I had a dream about the Twin Towers the morning of, the next day. I had a dream about the Twin Towers, like 8 o'clock in the morning. I'm like, it was a nightmare. It felt so real. People were running. It was two planes. They both collapsed. Something happened in DC. And she was like, oh my God, that sounds crazy. And literally like an hour later, everything started happening. It was like, it actually freaked me out. It was like really freaked me out. That was the scariest thing for me. And because I kind of feel like, maybe if I would have said something, I don't know. I mean, who would I tell? Mm-hmm. But I'm just, it always like bothers me that I had this premonition and this happened.
If that's real, you're a goddamn creep. And no one would have believed
you.
No, but
it is real.
So you should have no guilt. Right.
Yeah, I don't have any guilt, but I'm like, damn, you know, like so many people died and I had the exact premonition of exactly what happened the day
before. Actually, I take it back. You should have told people.
So
I blame you.
Really?
9/11
was
Natasha's
fault. Don't listen to
anything you said. Don't do that to me. Right? So that was the scariest thing for me because of so many people that
have
died.
You ever seen like spirits? Any like mediumish stuff?
Yes. When I was younger, I used to see a lot of spirits as a kid, mainly because I wasn't public with my ability. Mm-hmm. But as now that I'm an adult and I'm like public with it, I don't really see as many spirits. My husband thinks that he sees them, which I don't know. I think he's just fucking crazy. But when I was young, I used to see a lot of spirits in my bedroom. Yeah,
can you like tune into it now? Like if there's someone in particular that you want to see?
I don't consider myself a medium because mediums, they read people who crossed over. So I don't see medium. Mm-hmm. So I try not to connect with the dead. So usually like when I used to see spirits, I'm like, I'm actually freaked out.
So you've
about
made
it.
A decision to.
Yeah. Like I just don't like spirits. I think that it's scary. If you're freaking dead, leave me alone. Mm-hmm. I just don't like spirits.
Did you ever think that you having that dream caused 9/11? In this
do
universe.
Do not do this to me.
No, you see what I'm saying? This is why I cannot do DMT because of
you gotta
that.
You got to stop blaming 9/11. You got to stop blaming guests for 9/11. You do it every week.
Is this comedy? Yeah.
Don't worry about it.
Oh, my God.
Did your dream specify where the Bush did it?
Oh, that's a good question.
That's a good question.
On the podcast? That
should be a new segment. Do you think Bush did 9/11?
On the podcast?
Yes, please.
Really?
It's like, no, it's Trump's fault.
Who's to blame?
Can I just, like, shake my head, like, do I have to like say it?
That'd be cool if he did.
I think he did.
Bush
I think
himself.
He had something to do with it.
Something to do with it. So it's inside job.
Yes.
And do you think Osama bin Laden had anything to do with it?
Absolutely.
So them in cahoots.
Correct.
Interesting.
I did not expect this episode to go this way.
I'm sorry.
Very
we started off talking about shitting our pants.
I try not to talk like politics and stuff like that. Like people are always asking about politics. Is Trump going to be in office? Give me the lotto numbers.
Oh,
like
for
there's
sure.
certain things that I try to steer, especially like politics. Like I'm like,
Yeah, let's steer away from politics and into the lotto numbers. What do you got?
I know. Everyone,
pick three
that
or two.
That is the million.
I'll take the
if
box.
If I knew the lotto numbers, I would be rich. I wish I had the lotto numbers. Believe me. I wouldn't give it away. I would keep it for myself.
There's like the age old, like fucking hack fucking psychic, you know, anti-psychic thing. Ooh, a lot of numbers. Yeah. No, no, we'll just fucking.
Could you imagine?
How about
you...
that? I was gonna say sorry, but what about a person who wins the lotto then becomes a psychic? Because then you're like, yeah, I did it. Now I'm giving you your motherfucking money.
Known it all.
Wow. Yeah.
No one's done that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a great idea.
You had to go reverse.
It's like, yeah. Everyone that wins is some redneck from some bullshit town. So really they can't, they're not smart enough to figure that out.
Fucking codger that you want
to. And they always blow the money, but now they could like start a job. You know, they could also get a job out of it. A
side gig.
Yeah. A little side gig. Yeah.
I feel like your wife is going to get pregnant next year.
Oh, nice. Oh, Gary, you leaving it in?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. No pull. Good out. To know. No pull out.
Might have left it in on Saturday.
Yeah. Next year, 2020.
We should write these things down. So next year.
He'll remember. He won't forget. Believe me.
Yeah.
Like, I'll remember. When I'm buying the house, I'll be like, sure, holy right?
Nate, 2 or 3 years really? Property.
Yeah.
Gary,
you just wake up in
baby.
A bank somewhere. Like, I don't know how.
Netflix and baby.
Netflix and baby.
Yeah, Netflix and baby.
And then a Netflix.
Maybe it's going to be like an Ali Wong, and I'm just going to have a baby.
That's it, right? And on the Netflix movie, you're acting co-worker.
I know you got Shannon. Was you should have done something else with your life. So think about that.
I mean, I knew that already.
You should have been a stripper or a fucking whore of some kind.
That's what I hear every day working at Gas Digital.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's good.
Why aren't you a stripper or a whore? Do you have anything? You didn't tell Maddie anything.
Well, something's coming up to me with his wife and like entrepreneurship, like doing her own thing, you know, wanting to like run her own business and do her own thing. I don't know if she's doing that or she had that conversation with you, but I'm sensing that she's like doing her own business.
Doing her own thing, like leaving you.
Entrepreneurship is what I'm getting for her. Like running a business is what I'm picking up about your wife.
I mean, she takes care of half retards every now and again. I guess she could build a kennel to keep them in.
Has she
you talking about
anything?
Yourself?
Yes, she's with someone that is.
Full.
No. Has she ever mentioned anything to you about like wanting to start her own business or whatever? Because I see that she would do that.
She won't. No.
You think not?
No.
He has no faith in her.
She's weak. She can't run people.
He's not weak.
Yeah.
He's the worst. She's also not his wife yet because he won't propose after 15 years.
That's his wife by common law. This is his wife.
I'm still feeling her out.
Do you feel that he's going to propose in the next year?
No, I'm not picking that up.
You stink.
That's easy.
Is she listening to the show?
No, she doesn't listen to me when I talk to her at home.
She wants to get married, by the way.
Oh, shit.
I mean,
she's a lady over 30 and she wants to get married and have kids.
I mean, but it's like you guys are married. It's almost like she considers you to be her husband.
It's been almost 16 years, yeah.
Is it? Are we at almost 60 now? I just recently changed to 15 from 14.
Yeah, I mean, we're 3 months out, whatever the fuck it is. Four months out. Yeah.
God damn it, Maddie, you're the worst.
Because she like looks at him like her husband. I feel like she almost told people that you're her husband. Like,
yeah. Maybe she's the half retarded.
I thought I was having a stroke last week, and I called my wife a few times. Mm. That could mean something.
She should be after 15 years,
right?
Yeah.
Right?
<My wife.
laughs> Right? The worst. Do you have anything else? anything else to tell the three of us before we wrap?
No, I'm not really picking up anything. I see a successful career with you, which is very good. You're going to do very well in your comedy career, which is very exciting. And your wife is going to have a baby. So 2020 is a very promising year for you.
Cool.
So you should be very excited. Right.
Gary was here first.
Your podcast is actually going to go very well. I do see you expanding in terms of like additional co-host is what I'm sensing.
Replacement.
You're gonna replace
I mean, you don't need to be a fucking intuit to figure that shit out.
No. To figure out that he's going to be replaced?
Yeah.
No. I'm not saying that.
At this point, you're just giving us business advice.
No, right? So that would do very well for you in terms of the podcast and stuff like that. I'm seeing like you're going to do very well in 2020 in terms of financial. I see financial growth for you, which should be very exciting. Your money is going to grow. Like I see expansion for you from a financial perspective.
If it doesn't,
like
kill yourself. You're only getting older, Nate.
No, and that's actually a good thing.
You don't look great for your age.
He's going to do well financially next year. Like some great stuff in the pipeline for you that will help your finances grow. Is what I'm sensing for you.
I wonder what that is.
So you should be happy.
I have one question.
Drug dealer.
I'm sorry. Then you can go.
Go on.
Do you think the podcast will grow to the point where I can support myself on just this podcast? Mm-hmm.
Well, so what's coming up for me is you definitely pitching. You need to pitch and push for more advertisements. Mm-hmm. So the audience will grow. As a result of that, you'll get more like advertisement deals that's going to come in, which will support you financially. So that's when the money's going to start coming in. Okay. So when I say growth for you in terms of podcasts, I do sense larger audiences and advertisements coming in, which will help you from a financial standpoint.
Okay. We do have two.
You're going to have a tumor.
Say that.
It'll never be able to dance.
Yeah, exactly. No, right? So you will, that will be good for you. Because podcasts are going to go on
every. We do have two reads next week.
Wow. Yeah.
That's exciting.
Two ad reads
next week.
Okay. That's yeah. You're gonna pick up in terms of advertisements. Perfect. You're going to see that. So
that's all I want.
Keep doing what you're doing.
And I'm not going to get murdered by somebody climbing into my house.
You're going to get murdered by one of these guys.
I figured that. So,
yeah. I was literally just thinking, if she says no, I'm going to kill you. Just prove her wrong.
Right. Are you pointing at Brian or at Maddie or Maddie?
This is the main one who's going to kill you. I'm just letting you know.
Oh, Brian pointed at
her. We're all in on it.
Can't you tell?
This is the last show. And then that's why the show is going to grow, because I get murdered on air.
You don't like
the mainstream.
How are we going to get ads for that? After you're dead.
It'll be on Netflix.
Right? That'd be a good show, actually.
Got it.
Podcast murder? I don't know.
Do you have another question you want to ask? Mm-mm. All right, guys. It's been a great episode. Thank you guys so much for being here. I want to do a quick round of plugs and we'll wrap up. I'll start with you, Maddie.
You can follow me and see my almost wife every now and again on Instagram at Jester Skulls and Twitter and whatever. Who gives a fuck? Cares.
Uh-huh. You can follow me on Instagram at talktotash922, talktotash922 on Instagram.
Gary?
Cool. I'll be at Town Hall with Nate Bargatze on this Saturday, November, I think it's 9th, but anyway, it's this Saturday. And then on Sunday in Washington, D.C. at the Warner Theater.
Oh, well. Awesome. Congratulations. Yeah,
thanks.
Awesome. And website for future dates?
Oh, GaryVeter.com.
Awesome. Neat.
You can follow me everywhere at the Kickin' It Pod. yeah. And I have other interests, as you can see. That's it for me. You know the deal.
Now, follow me on Instagram at ShannonLee6982. And, okay, wherever you listen to the podcast, you can also watch live for free every single Monday at 8 p.m. Eastern at gasdigitalnetwork.com/live. The best way to promote the show is to use promo code TTI to get a subscription. You get a 2-week free trial plus access to all the amazing shows on Gas Digital Network, including Legion of Skanks, Real Ass Podcast, Believe You Me, SDR Show, No Disrespect, blah, blah, blah. You can buy merch. We have new shirts out, podcastmerch.com. We have the two new shirts and the mug, which is very fun. I don't know. I'm waiting for it to show on the screen. I'll keep talking. It'll pop up momentarily. And leave a rating or review on iTunes. And we pick one lucky reviewer every month-ish to win a mug or a t-shirt. There we go. Look how fun. That's the new
shirt. Nice.
Oh, yay. There's a new hoodie, t-shirt.
I like it.
It's fun. There'll be a new mug soon. The old ones were discontinued. But did I get everything? Rating review. Oh, if you want to submit a story for any of the segments, a worst date story, bad things, or scary things, send it to thethingispodcast@gmail.com. It never gets said during the show anymore. Now it's just weird when I hit it at the end of the show. And follow the show everywhere at thethingisshow@gmail.com. Thank you so much for listening, everyone. Back next week. Bye, guys.
Bye.
Thank you. Bye.